Are we going to continue down the same road with the same Senator Norman Coleman representing us in the U.S. Senate, who doesn't represent us in the U.S. Senate, who only represents big business, oil, banks, insurance? He has voted time and time again to let the Iraqi war continue and continue and continue. This is very important to Minnesotans, but we can't find Norman Coleman to discuss why he keeps voting for the Iraqi war. Why did he vote that the Medicaid cannot have bids for the medicine that our elderly need? Why are they paying so much for their prescription medicine? It's very urgent that we change. I am running in the Republican primary on September 9th against Norman Coleman. It is your chance to cast your vote against Norman Coleman by voting for Jack Shepard. If we eliminate Norman Coleman from the United States Senate, we will get a person who will stop the Iraqi war, who will work for the Minnesota people, will not have millions of dollars given to him by the big lobbies that he flies all over America in their jets. They pay for his hotels, for his dinner, for everything. So it's very important on September 9th to vote for Jack Shepard, to cast your vote to eliminate Norman Coleman from the U.S. Senate. This is one very important thing I have to read to you now. I'm very sorry I have to make this announcement, but it was requested that I make it, okay? If you served in Iraq and you have drinking any of the water, eaten any of the food, or taken any showers, their water has been contaminated. There are lethal pathogens in that water, and Norman Coleman was notified this and he failed to investigate. Specifically, out of the 67 water treatment plants in Iraq, 63 of them weren't providing safe drinking water because the contractors were not using chlorine. And these same contractors gave massive donations to Norman Coleman. Where do you think he got the $7-8 million? From us normal Minnesotan people? No, he got big chunks of money from big business who he always voted for. So remember, when you're voting on September 9th, you decide, are you happy with Norman Coleman? Are we going to go down the same street of a guy who doesn't listen to you? He's got his own agenda. He says he wants to get the people together. He says he's partisan. But in 2003, 98% of the time, he voted with the Republican Party. And then after the massacre in 2004, he started going a little over on the other aisle, but he still ends up about 96% voting with the Republican Party after his first 5 years in the U.S. Senate. Is that partisanship? Is that working together? He makes up things and he tells stories which he believes, and he wants you to believe him. So look at Norman Coleman's record. Don't listen to what he says. Just look at his record. After me, I'm going to show you some videos, some people talking, where is Norman Coleman? Journalists ask him, why won't he come here for an interview? He's got his millions of dollars to attack, I guess, the Democratic fellow because he had a bad accountant. What does a bad accountant have to do with a record? Norman Coleman's record is like running on the safety record of the Titanic before it sailed. Thank you very much.
Well, just leave it on the table. Try to say, lady. Are you excited about the convention?
Actually, I'm excited for coverage. One, I'm originally from Brooklyn, New York, so it's
nice.
kind of coming home.
Nice. By the way, you would think in New York, Brooklyn might get some applause. Nothing. It is.
I go to Brooklyn every day. All right.
Hard to imagine growing up as a Jewish kid, Democrat in Brooklyn, New York, to be the Republican senator from Minnesota, but here I am. Things happen.
You were a Democrat in New York, and now you're a Republican in Minnesota.
It's,
you know, some might call that, I don't know, a flip-flop.
Sir, indeed.